Hello and welcome to the Pencil Tutors channel. My name is Nandiga and today I will be giving a biology lesson on the cell structure and function. First of all, before we get started, it is important to know what exactly is a cell. Well, a cell is the basic unit of all life, which means all living things like humans, animals, and plants are all made up of cells. Cells, on the other hand, are made up of subcellular structures within the cell that form their own specific functions. All these subcellular components are known as organelles. Today, I will be focusing on the structure and function of two major types of cells, which are animal cells and plant cells. So, let's get started. Now, let's take a closer look at the organelles within an animal cell. First of all, we have the nucleus. The nucleus is known as the largest component inside a cell. It is also known as the brain of the cell. Let's take a closer look at the structure of a nucleus. The nucleus is known to have a double membrane. Another name for the membrane of the nucleus is the nuclear envelope. The nuclear envelope is filled with pores. These pores are called nuclear pores. Within the nucleus, there is nucleoplasm. Within the nucleoplasm lies the nucleolus and chromatin. Chromatin contains DNA, which contains genetic information of the cell. Now, let's take a look at the functions of a nucleus. A nucleus controls the cell activity, and it also contains DNA, which is deoxyribonucleic acid, that determines the cell characteristics and its metabolic functions. Next, we have ribosomes. Ribosomes are small, compact, and spherical granules that consist of protein and RNA. Ribosomes can be either found attached to the surface of rough endoplasmic reticulums or found freely lying within the cytoplasm of the cell. The function of ribosomes is as the site for protein synthesis. Other than that, we have the cytoplasm. The cytoplasm consists of a jelly-like medium that contains all the components that are suspended within the cell. Inside the cytoplasm, there are organic compounds such as lipids, proteins, and carbohydrates. The function of cytoplasm is as a medium for all the biochemical reactions inside of the cell. Next is the endoplasmic reticulum of the cell. The endoplasmic reticulum is a system of interconnected folded platen sacs. There are two types of endoplasmic reticulums, which is the rough endoplasmic reticulum and the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Here is a diagram to show the clear difference between the rough endoplasmic reticulum and the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. As you can see here, on the rough endoplasmic reticulum, there are ribosomes attached to its surface, whereas on the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, there are no ribosomes attached to its surface. Now, let's look at the function of the rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. The rough endoplasmic reticulum functions to transport proteins that are synthesized by the ribosomes that are attached on its surface, whereas the smooth endoplasmic reticulum functions to transport glycerol and lipids. Other than that, the smooth endoplasmic reticulum also acts as a detoxification of drugs and metabolic byproducts. After that, we have the Golgi apparatus. The Golgi apparatus looks very similar to the endoplasmic reticulums that we have learned before this, but it is easy to differentiate the Golgi apparatus and endoplasmic reticulum due to its position inside the cell and its shape. The Golgi apparatus is a stack of parallel flattened sacs, whereas the endoplasmic reticulum, as mentioned before, is interconnected within each other. Other than that, the Golgi apparatus is normally located further from the nucleus compared to the endoplasmic reticulum, which is normally located nearby the nucleus of the cell. Now, let's take a closer look at the structure of the Golgi apparatus. First of all, the Golgi apparatus has a single membrane called a cisternae. Other than that, there are incoming transport vesicles that normally come from the rough endoplasmic reticulum that will bind to the cis face of the Golgi apparatus. There are also secretory vesicles that will bud off from the transphase of this Golgi apparatus. As for the function of the Golgi apparatus, the Golgi apparatus functions to process, modify, pack, and transport chemicals such as proteins, carbohydrates, and glycoproteins. Next, we have the powerhouse of the cell, which is the mitochondrion, or plurally known as mitochondria. The function of the mitochondria is to generate energy through the glucose oxidation process during cellular respiration in the form of ATP molecules. As you can see here, the mitochondria is spherical or rod-shaped. It has a double membrane, which means it has a smooth outer membrane and a folded layer of an inner membrane. The inner membrane is known as the cristae, whereas the fluid inside the mitochondria is known as a matrix. Fun fact, unlike other organelles, mitochondria contains its very own DNA inside of it. The next organelle is a lysosome. The lysosome is a small spherical sac that is enclosed with a single membrane and has hydrolytic enzyme inside of it. The lysosome functions to hydrolyze complex organic molecules such as protein, nucleic acid, and lipids. Other than that, it also functions to break down bacteria and components of damaged cells. Another component inside the animal cell are centrioles, which are small cylindrical components that exist within pairs. They are made up of complex arrangement of microtubules and they do not exist inside plant cells. The function of centrioles are to form spindle fibers during cell division. Another important organelle to know is the plasma membrane that surrounds all the content of the cell. Let's take a closer look at the structure of a plasma membrane. The plasma membrane is a thin and elastic film that is made up mainly of lipids and proteins. This plasma membrane that we have is semi-permeable. This means it only allows certain substances to go into and out of the cell. The function of the plasma membrane is to separate the cell content from the external environment, to control the movement of substances in and out of a cell, and lastly, it allows exchange of nutrients, respiratory gases, and waste materials within the cell. Now that we have settled all the organelles in animal cells, it's time to move on to the organelles within plant cells. Mostly all the organelles inside animal cells exist within plant cells, except for certain organelles such as centrioles. Additional to that, there are a few organelles within the plant cell that do not exist in animal cells. For example, we have chloroplasts. The chloroplast contains a chlorophyll that absorbs sunlight and converts it into chemical energy during the photosynthesis process carried out by plants. As we can see from this diagram, the chloroplast is normally oval in shape. It has a double membrane and contains chlorophyll pigments inside of it. This structure is very similar to an organelle we've learned before this. Yes, it is similar to the mitochondria. But how do we differentiate two of these? It's pretty simple actually. The mitochondria normally looks like a hot dog. It has a folded inner membrane. Looks like this. The chloroplast, on the other hand, has a stack of thylakoids. Therefore, it looks a little like this. Plant cells also have a cell wall. The cell wall is not present within animal cells. The cell wall is a strong and rigid outer layer and is made from a cellulose fiber. Unlike the plasma membrane, the cell wall is fully permeable to any substance. The cell wall functions to maintain the shape of the cell and to provide mechanical support to the plant cell. Next, we have the vacuole. The vacuole has a single outer membrane that is known as the tonoplast. Other than that, inside the tonoplast, it contains cell sap. This cell sap contains water, organic acids, sugars, amino acids, enzymes, mineral salts, oxygen, carbon dioxide, and metabolic byproducts. Young plants tend to have many small vacuoles, while mature plants have larger vacuoles. The vacuoles in animal cells are sometimes present, but they are very small. The vacuole functions to maintain the turgidity of the cell, In unicellular organisms, the vacuole contracts during osmoregulation, osmosis, and excretion. Now that we've learned about all the organelles inside a plant and animal cell, it's time to recap our lesson before we end it. Some of the similarities between plant and animal cells is that both of them have nucleus, cytoplasm, plasma membrane, Golgi apparatus, mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, and ribosomes. More importantly, what are the differences between plant cells and animal cells? As I mentioned before, due to the presence of cell wall, the plant cells have a thick shape, whereas the animal cells do not have a thick shape. They have cell wall, chloroplast, and large vacuoles within plant cells, whereas in animal cells, they do not have cell walls, they do not have chloroplast, and they have no vacuole, and if it is present, it is small. Plant cells store carbohydrate in the form of starch, while animal cells store carbohydrate in the form of glycogen. Last but not least, animal cells have centrioles, while plant cells do not have centrioles. Before I end the lesson, let's do a quick question time so that we can see if you really understood this topic or not. Let's start off with an easy question. Diagram 1.1 shows a root hair cell. Name P and Q. When answering questions, it is important to underline the key points and really study the diagram given because it can help a lot when answering questions. Here we have a root hair cell. A root hair cell means that this cell is a plant cell and not an animal cell. Now, when we look closely at this diagram, P is pointing towards the most outmost layer of the cell. Can you guess what this is? That's right. This is a cell wall. What about Q? Q is located near the vacuole, and there is only one organelle that looks like Q within the whole cell. Can you guess what it is? Q is the nucleus of the cell. For those of you who got the answer right, good job. Next question, state the function of R. Before we state the function of R, we need to know what exactly is R. R is the vacuole. The ideal answer for this question would be the function of R, which is the vacuole, is to maintain the turgidity of the cell. Any other logical answers are also accepted, but since the marks allocated for this question is only one, make sure you give only one function of the vacuole. This question is a little bit trickier than the ones before this. The cell in diagram 1.1 cannot carry out photosynthesis. Why? First of all, we need to know which organelles are involved in photosynthesis. That is right, it's the chloroplast. If you look closely in diagram 1.1, we can see organelles such as the nucleus, vacuole, and mitochondria, but we do not see anything like the chloroplast. Therefore, the answer to this question is, the cell in diagram 1.1 cannot carry out photosynthesis because of the absence of chloroplast. Since the marks allocated for this question is only one, there is no need for further explanation, and you can just give a simple answer like this. Give an example of another cell similar to the cell in diagram 1.1. A diagram 1.1 shows the root hair cell. So, first of all, we need to know the cell that is similar needs to be a plant cell. What else do we need to know? It can't just be any plant cell because diagram 1.1 does not have a chloroplast. Therefore, we need to find of cells that have the structure of plant cells but do not have chloroplast. That means they do not undergo photosynthesis. Can you think of any? The answer is onion cells, mushroom, and mold. Just write one, since there's only one mark allocated for this question. Last but not least, we have reached the final question, which is also the hardest question I have picked today. Explain the importance of root hair cell to contain more organelle S. First of all, we need to identify what is organelle S. Organelle S is a mitochondria. What is the function of mitochondria? Mitochondria functions to produce energy in the form of ATP. Why do we need this ATP energy in this cell? We need ATP energy in this cell because the intake of nutrients into the root hair cell is via active transport. Active transport requires ATP energy in order for it to occur. Further explanation on this topic will be given in future videos. Since this question is only 2 marks, you only need 2 points. The first point should be the uptake of minerals and nutrients into the root hair cell via active transport. Therefore, it needs more ATP energy, and ATP energy is produced by organelle S, which is the mitochondria. Now, we have reached the end of our lesson. That is all for me. Thanks for watching the video and be sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel. Don't forget, we post videos every Monday, Wednesday and Friday covering physics, mathematics and biology.